load of wild turkeys. Look, Charlie. You see them?
You have arrived.
So we have just arrived at Magic Kingdom. We've parked the car and we're now walking towards the ferry or the monorail, whichever one we get on. So just over there in the distance. So we had to park quite a way. What is it now? It's about 11 o'clock, half past 10, 11 o'clock. So it's a bit later in the day, a bit later than we wanted to, but is what it is. Yeah, so see you when we get on the boat. Okay, so we've now made it through security. So now we've got the choice of going on the boat or getting the monorail. So we've decided to get on the boat because that's what Jack wants to do. And yeah, we're going to go on the boat. So you can see the monorail just up there. And grab a coffee or anything like that. It's the ferry boat that we're going to go to. So next to the boats is actually my favourite resort, which is the Polynesian. So we might get to have a quick glance at that. There's a Polynesian just over there. Thank you. So now we're on the boat. Perfect little spot just here for the boys to have a look. So I wonder if we can see right into. See the back porch there, and that gives you a perfect view of Magic Kingdom. One day we will afford to go on the Polynesian on the bungalows. Although I reckon it's probably really noisy at night time because you've got these boats going backwards and forwards all the time and they're not quiet.
I don't think it'd be that noisy.
You don't think so?
No. Maybe it's just noisy when you're on the boat.
Yeah, maybe. But yeah, definitely going to have a look around.
I wonder if it's busy today. It's a Monday, isn't it?
Don't Monday. It? Hopefully not. We'll see. You can also see, if I just turn you around, you can see the Grand Floridian. We're on the way. We've started moving now. We're getting a really nice view of Grand Floridian over there. You can even see the beach. Zoom in there. It's all man-made, this lake. So there was no lake here, and they designed it specifically for Disney.
And scaffolding.
It's
under construction, yeah.
What's that hotel over there, Soph?
What's that?
What's that hotel over there?
I don't know. It's a new one.
Comment in description, in the comments, if you know what that is. So, on one of these islands, I think it was that one, there used to be a water park. What was the water park called? Was it Wet and Wild?
No, not Wet and Wild.
What was it called?
It wasn't Wet and Wild.
So there used to be a water park. It just didn't work out because all the other water parks opened up and it lost popularity. I think there was a few bits and pieces that happened. Anyway, they found a brain-eating amoeba there. So that's not good. I think there are plans to build something else there on that island. River Country is what it was called. So that hotel over there, it looks like it's a brand new one, under construction. Let's have a look at that.
I'm not sure if it's that brand new or they are.
Get a boat ride over there.
For your safety, please stay in water until your safety dock.
Oh yeah, you can go past it.
Because this is a free floating vessel, you can let it bounce around the bit. If you are sadly more safe, we ask that you clear the stairway. Everyone else, please remain where you are until we complete our dock.
Yeah, so what they're saying is we should go on the boats. I like the free transport and then we can go and get a good look at it. Maybe we should put it back.
So just over there, you can see a really good view of the Contemporary.
The monorail actually goes right through the middle of that.
Alright, so we are literally just about to go into the park.
Halloween decorations are up, so we're looking forward to getting in and looking at all of the different rides and stuff. Just have a look quickly at these pumpkins. They've got massive pumpkins just there. They've got all the autumnal flowers and all the great seasonal stuff. Right, what is the first port of call, so? What do you reckon?
We always do pirates, don't
pirates,
we?
Yeah.
Pirates, the Caribbean, so
let's do pirates then.
We do pirates first?
Yeah. So we're off to Pirates of the Caribbean then. Decorations. For Halloween, right? Look at all these big pumpkins, look. Because it was shellfish. Come on, look at these two over here, Jack. Look. Look at them, Jack. They're cool, aren't they? Hey. Very cool. What do you think of the decorations, Jack? Yeah, really cool. Look, Charlie, all these decorations for Halloween. 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 All right, so heading down Main Street, USA, at Walt Disney World. Here we are. So all the decorations are brilliant. You see all these pumpkins up there as well? They look really good, so people are taking the time to carve them. If you want to get a Disney balloon, I'm not sure how much they are, but if you ever lose it or it gets popped, they will replace it free of charge. How good is that? So it looks like it's got a fresh... Has it got a fresh paint on it? It looks like it's got a fresh layer of paint on it, doesn't it? Jack's decided he wants to have a little roll around on the grass. Why not? Nice bit of music while the band comes along. You all right, Jack? Is that good, is it? Little Disney band just there. How good's that band, Jack? Do you like it? What are you doing? Right, let's get to Pirates of the Caribbean. On the way to Pirates.
Love Pirates.
It's a really nice day today. I think it's meant to be about 34 today. So, and there's less clouds in the sky, which is nice. So we're meant to have really good weather all week this week. So we'll get some nice footage this week, I think.
For the dull whip, should I get the boys one?
Yeah, I think you should get a dull whip because you can have one, can't you? So she's going to get a dull whip. From here, it's like sunshine trees, there's orange, I think. Let's see, look, I love a you float. They're all different types of float, the dull whip. Yeah, so she's going to get one of them. So I've just got a dull whip. I'll try it, she's got brain freeze now. That's what you get. That's what you get. So the boys have got one each as well. I had a taste. Disgusting. Don't like it at all. But the boys, they're enjoying it. Do you like it, Charlie? Yeah. We also just went past the camel on Aladdin. And it spit. Spat on the kids. Not a real camel. Here we go, look. That's the Pirates of the Caribbean. Just there. Lightning Lane approved. Okay, so we are now entering Pirates of the Caribbean. So this is Lightning Lane. Give you some idea of how busy it is today. What the standard time?
Yeah, normally it's like 15 minutes, isn't it?
It's a good ride.
Yeah. I think the Disneyland Paris one is meant to be better.
Buzzing for the pirate ride. Let's go, Pirates of the Caribbean. Alright, so we just went on Pirates of the Caribbean. That was a good ride, wasn't it? So,
yeah, good.
What do you think? That one or Paris is better? Better? You like Paris better? To be honest with you, although Paris is all bongy bongy and French, I think Paris one is better as well.
Much better.
Yeah.
Much better.
It's got a bigger, better drop. It's got a couple of drops in Paris, isn't it?
Yeah. So, and you can see it more. It's more clear, rather.
Yeah.
That one's very dark.
It is better.
The story's better in Paris.
Yeah. So now we're just going in the tiki rooms. I think we're just about to go in, so let's go. Come on, Jack, get in front. All the birds at work and the flowers grow. All right, so that was the tiki rooms. Not really impressed with the tiki room. It's a bit of an oldie graphic. But yeah, it was quite interesting, I suppose. The kids enjoyed it. Popped into Tortuga Tavern and we're going to get some food. This is what we're going to get. We look up there. We're going to get a pulled pork sandwich, some orange chicken, and a slaw dog. We've got the orange chicken tenders coming, the pork sandwich, and a hot dog. So that comes to $35.22. It's not that bad really, I suppose. You're looking at just over 10 quid a meal. So I'll show you in a second, yeah. So this is what we've got. We've got the chicken tenders, pork sandwich, they all come with chips, and then Jack got a hot dog. Is that nice, Jack? Your hot dog was lovely, was it? Right, so Jack enjoyed his hot dog. He only ate half. He was only little, and they're quite big, I suppose. My pulled pork sandwich was quite nice. It was a light bite kind of thing. These little homemade chips that they do, they're quite nice. Sophie, how was your chicken?
Yeah, it's really nice.
Yeah?
There's so much salt, which is nice. Where I've had the one at Animal Kingdom, we had that to share, didn't we?
Yeah.
The chicken. And it's the same chicken, same salt, but there was no salt when it was at Animal Kingdom. It's dry as anything about it. But this was really, really nice. I'm just struggling because obviously, as I've said before, I've had a gastric sleeve, I can't really eat anything. So I had four tenders and I've managed two. In my brain, I'm thinking I'm going to go for it, I'm going to try again. But I've got a real, like, full feeling, so I just know that one more bite and that'd be me going over. So then, you see, Chris is going to finish it, or whoever else wants it. I've tried to offer it to the boys, but I don't want it.
Yep, that's one benefit. Okay, so now we're on our way to Jungle Cruise. We're going to have a little plod down the river. They normally tell you jokes and stuff like that as you go around, so let's see if we get a good one and yeah, let's try it out. Here we all are. And Noah's having a little sleep. He's been so good on the holiday. He really has.
It does work quite
well. There we go, it does. Well, you don't have to go on the app or nothing, it just does it. That's wicked, isn't it? So, Sophie's got a smart watch, an iWatch, and she's been using a...
I linked it to my wallet.
Yeah, you linked it to your wallet, and she can use that.
Well, it's got Jack's, all of us on it.
Oh, it's got all of us on it, so she could technically get us all in. Wow, look at this. Here we go, we're going to go on this, Charlie.
Parents, watch your kids. We're clear. We're out of here. Wave goodbye to the nice people on the dock.
did the river cruise. Yeah, it was really good fun. Some good jokes on there, weren't there, Rob?
Yeah.
You enjoyed them?
Yeah,
chuckling away. Chuckling away, a couple of good jokes. Boys enjoyed going around the river, seeing all the animals, the fake animals. Now we're just going through Frontierland and we're making our way to, I think, Peter Pan's. Peter Pan, Flight of Pan or something like that. Yes, that's where we're headed to next. Just show you a little bit of Frontierland, I guess. Ah, Tiana's Food Palace. Well, Tiana's Cafe is going to be here. I think that's coming at the end of this month. Not quite there yet. Yeah, a little bit gutted that. Oh, so this is Thunder Mountain. No, the new River Rapid one. And it's going to be themed around Princess and the Frog. And it's under construction, look. Wish that was done now, because it's one of our favourite films. So just behind me over here, a couple of weeks ago, it was a black bear. They had shut this part of the park. They don't know where it went. I believe they don't know where it went. Hopefully there's not one there today. If we do see a black bear, I'll let you know.
We have got to a restaurant and we are going to watch a parade and you're going to watch it with us.
Yeah, what he said. Apparently that was the main parade. By that account, I would have thought that Paris has got two marks on the scoreboard so far. They've got better parades and Pirates of the Caribbean's better in France. So ups and downs. Obviously the weather's much better here than it is in France. And the atmosphere's better here than it is in France. But this bit's really busy. Jesus, look at this. I think this is just because of the last bits of the parade, isn't it? Over there is where you get onto the boat. Old steamboat, really. Liberty Bell, rather. That's what it's called. That's really busy, isn't it? And there's the Liberty Tree Tavern. So right now we've got a lightning lane booked for Peter Pan's flight. So we're going to go and do that. Oh, there's loads of bubbles. Just push through. Yeah, whatever, yeah. Yeah, just got to fight through this crowd and get there. It's the only thing.
So we'll see you when we get there, I suppose. So it's Monday today. Didn't think it was really going to be this busy in the park, but maybe it's just always busy in this park, don't it? One thing you can do when you come to Disney is look at the Hall of Presidents. And this goes through all the different presidents in US history. I wonder if anybody can tell me how many there are in the comments. I wonder how many of you are going to get it right. And there's like different, I think there's a show as well, different presidents. Bore us all to death by looking at all of them, but there's old Walt Disney, three levels of three masons. There's one on Washington. Who's on the bills? There's some first ladies. There's Reagan, Wilson, oh, and Jefferson. He's on the bills. So yeah, that's all the presidents. I mean, if you go in the show, you can actually see the individual presidents themselves, but I'm not going to bore you with that. We have some Disney content, so let's get back to it. So they've gone in a Christmas shop. It's actually really big, actually. It goes all the way through there. It's bigger than it looks, the facade on the outside. Ah! I found them! Oh, here we go, the old Christmas sleigh, Jack. Say, yeah! That's the old Christmas shop. Oh, I'll just tell them something. They've got these Christmas shops everywhere, all the Christmas stuff in them. Nice aircon in here. You know, look, if you've got girls, you can get yourself a nice Christmas Disney princess stocking. I've got more of the baubles and stuff like that. To be honest with you, I think the best Christmas shop is probably Disney Springs. It's bigger, it's not as busy, well, it wasn't when we went, and there's probably more in it. Plus, when you're going around a theme park, do you want bags of shopping? Nah. Alright, so we've made our way over to Peter Pan's. Probably said I'm going to do that about 10 times, but here we are anyway, regardless. So, next to a small world, which is just there as well. And yeah, this is Peter Pan's, that's what we're going to go on right now. So we're just about to get on the ride, there was a little bit of a delay. I don't know what it was. But yeah, we're just about to get on.
Broke.
I am broke, yeah. Yeah. Or Disney broke me.
Yeah, that's
Disney.
I am
most
broke.
Most expensive holiday ever, I've seen that one.
Another one. It literally is. This is literally the most expensive holiday we've ever had, I think. Apart from Santorini, I think that might have been more.
See why people only come here once in their life.
No, because it's very expensive. Very, very expensive. Right, this is the queue, isn't it? Right, we are off to last ride of the day, which I believe is going to be the Little Mermaid. So we're just walking there now. We did stop and have a couple of chicken nuggets, which I think it's really worth putting on camera.
Right,
but
right,
yeah,
there.
We did. We stopped. He's doing it again. Look. Charlie, the little monkey, is spraying people as we walk past in that pram. Didn't ya? Ah, there's Gaston's Tavern over there. Oh look, due to adverse wind and weather conditions, Some areas may be closed prior to and during the night's fireworks performance. We apologise for any inconvenience this may cause. Gaston Tavern's got some really nice food in there. Massive Cinnabon? It's like that anyway. Nice sandwiches. It's got a real nice vibe in there as well, actually. I remember that from last time we came. This is somewhere we haven't been, which would be a nice one to go. It's Be Our Guest restaurant. It's actually themed like the castle in Beauty and the Beast. Take a look at that. See the castle up the top there. That's Beast's Castle.
So they do, the wines they do is private label champagne and wines.
Oh, okay.
So $21 for a glass or $85.
What's possibly the only place in Disney where you can get an alcoholic beverage or Magic Kingdom?
They've got sparkling wines, $11.
And what's that for?
But
that's like
a Charles
did
blah, 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 blah,
blah, French. All I heard then was, blah, 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 blah. What are you saying,
what? Where's Mumble?
Oh, I'll just take your pictures of Jack.
Oh.
What are you saying?
No, it's just all French. Like, I was just looking at the menu.
Yeah.
And it's all obviously
French, oh, yeah, because it's in France. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, it's like for a bottle.
Or a glass. Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, look. Chardonnay. $130.
$150.
$150.
Oh, they do beer and cider as well.
Oh. Where's that?
That's in the Be Our Guest.
Be Our Guest,
the restaurant.
You have to book that and have a booking.
That's the only place you've got alcohol if you want
a booze. Oh, okay. There's Gaston's Tavern. Jack's gone to have a look at the fountain. Look at that, it's good, isn't it? So wishing well. Oh, you chuck a coin in there and then make a wish. Ask Mama. Say, ask Mummy. He wants a coin. He wants a coin to chuck in. Come on. Get him a coin. And we're going to throw a coin in. There he goes to throw his coin in. That's it. Good boy. Did you do it? Good boy. Quickly, just come in here, quickly. Oh, here we go. Look at this. It's Gaston's Tavern. Huh? There you go, look, Gaston's Tavern. It's just a nice place with a bit of air conditioning. You've got a massive Gaston's chair just there in the corner. Just like the film, really. Come on in, let's go.
I chucked the coin in.
You chucked the coin in and did the wish, didn't you? He's off. So they've got really big steins in there, and no beer.
Did you complain?
No, well, I should do, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
Because you can go in there, you can have apple juice.
This frigging park is prejudiced.
It is prejudiced against adults.
Beer drinkers.
Against beer drinkers. So you can have a big stein of beer with apple juice, that's it.
I'm going to take the call.
I just don't see the point. Especially it's supposed to be Gaston's Tavern. You should have beer in it.
They're anti-beerists.
They are. They're beerists.
Yeah, they're beerists.
They are. They're being beerists. Yeah.
That's illegal.
It should be illegal.
Yeah.
Comment down below if you think that they should be able to serve a nice, cold, fresh, crisp beer in Gaston's Tavern. I think they should. It makes sense. All right, we have arrived. Oh, there's the buggy park in there. We've arrived at the ride about the girl who stalks the bloke. Even grows legs so she can go out and stalk him on land and find out where he is.
We're going on that ride.
All right, here we go. Just about to get on the lightning lane. Ah, some turkey legs over there. Gross. Comment down below if you like turkey legs. For me, hell no. That is disgusting. That is definitely not a beer moon. So here we go. So again, it might be deceiving, but it looks like, kind of looks like this is more busy than the standby queue, but the standby queue probably goes round and around and around and around.
I just spoke to a cast member because I thought it's really busy and I just wanted to ask, because normally on Little Mermaid it's normally about 10 minute wait time every time we pay, like to Disney. And she said it's because it's a Monday, and Mondays and Tuesdays are the worst day to come because everyone starts their holiday and they're like, oh, we're going to go Magic Kingdom on the first day. Where at home in the UK, it would be like, oh, Monday, everyone's at work, we'll go Monday. But it's not like that here. And also, it's not a ticket event tonight, so you've got Boo to You, which is Wednesdays, Thursdays and Fridays and Saturdays, I think, she said. But it's better off. So, what was I going to say? So she said that Wednesdays, Thursdays and Fridays is a good day to come to Magic Kingdom. The rest of the time is going to be really, really busy. So at least we know that now. Epcot is a no-go on a Saturday and a Sunday because it's going to be really busy. Animal Kingdom, it doesn't matter, Animal Kingdom. It's always going to be the same, which we found it was really quiet when we went. I mean, the safari was only 10 minute wait. So I just asked and I thought, it's got to be a reason behind it, because not being funny, it feels like when it was at Christmas, it was really busy, weren't it? So it feels the same sort of atmosphere. Everything, all the wait times, 120 or 60 minutes plus, and that's just crazy, especially for Little Mermaid, because to be honest with you, it's not a great ride, is it? So,
yeah. An oldie but a goldie.
Yeah. I won't wait 65 minutes for this. But we're in the lightning lane anyway, so we still have to wait. I think it's probably about 20 minutes in the lightning lane.
Alright.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, Ariel fell in love with a human. Then King Triton got all mad and tossed the bank in the crab to watch over.
That's going to be the end of today's video. I hope you've enjoyed watching it as much as we've enjoyed making it. And yeah, we've had a really good time here in Disney Magic Kingdom. We've not got as much done as what we'd wanted to have got done, but you know, we have got three small children, so we have to take our time with things, and we can't really spend all day at the park because you know, they need to sleep, they've got to have something to eat, and so have we. It's quite tiring dealing with the kids. And there's a group and we all want to do different things. But we're now going to go home, jump in the swimming pool and relax, and get ready for tomorrow. So tomorrow we're probably going to be doing Universal, so we've got some Universal vlogs coming up. So don't forget to ring that little bell so you'll get notifications when we upload new content. And yeah, so please like, share and subscribe. And we'll see you next time. Bye.